Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Monday, the feast of St. Ambrose, Bishop and Doctor of the Church. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. In the midst of the church, he opened his mouth, and the Lord filled him with a spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who made the Bishop, St. Ambrose, a teacher of the Catholic faith, and a model of apostolic courage, raise up in your church men after your own heart, to govern her with courage and wisdom. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will exult. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with the abundant flowers and rejoice with the joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them. The splendor of Carmel and Sharon, they will see the glory of the Lord. The splendor of our God, strengthen the hands that the feeble, make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with the vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eye of the blind be opened. The ears of the deaf will be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert, and rivers in the steep steppe. The burning sands will become pools, and the thirsty ground spring of water. The abode where jackals lurk will be a marsh for the reed and papyrus. A highway will be there, called the Holy Way. No one unclean may pass over it, nor fools go astray on it. No lion will be there, nor beast of prey go up to be met upon it. It is for those with a journey to make, and on it the redeemed will walk. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with the everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness, sorrow and mourning would flee. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, let our response be, our God will come to save us.
Our God will come to save us.
I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him. Glory dwelling in our land.
Our God will come to save us.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from the heaven.
Our God will come to save us.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps.
Our God will come to save us. Alleluia, alleluia. Behold, the King will come, the Lord of the earth, and he himself will lift the yoke of our captivity. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
One day, as Jesus was teaching, Pharisees and teachers of the law, who had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem, were sitting there, and the power of the Lord was with him for healing. And some men brought on a stretcher a man who was paralyzed. They were trying to bring him in and set him in his presence, but not finding a way to bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and lowered him on the stretcher through the tiles into the middle in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "As for you, your sins are forgiven." Then the scribes and Pharisees began to ask themselves, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who but God alone can forgive sins?" Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them in reply, "What are you thinking in your hearts? Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the one who was paralyzed, "I say to you, rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He stood up immediately before them, picked up what he had been lying on, and went home glorifying God. Then astonishment seized them, and they glorified God, and struck with awe, they said, "We have seen incredible things today." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, here you have a very powerful healing story in our Gospel for today, the second week of Advent. So we begin the second week of Advent. And here the powerful healing story, and one of the things that I think that is very, very nice and very, very important to reflect on in this healing story is the holistic approach of Christ. That Christ heals a person, heals us to move towards the wholeness of our person. If you notice, the first thing that the Lord heals is the spiritual healing. Your sins are forgiven. Remember that during the time that sickness is always very often associated with sinfulness. So the Lord understood that. So he first heals the interior of the man. Your sins are forgiven you. And of course, later on, because of the challenge of the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, he actually does the physical healing. No? But here, again, the point that I invite you to reflect on is that our encounter with Christ brings us wholeness. Our encounter with Christ brings us healing. Siguro yun yung mahalaga. No? Ang ating relasyon sa Panginoong Hesukristo ay nagdadala dapat ng pagbubuo at paghilom ng ating pagkatao. Pagbubuo ng pagkatao natin, hindi lamang sa spiritual, kundi pati sa physical, sa psychological, but merong siyang pagiging buo ang ating pagkatao. And I think that is one of the greatest, in a sense, the greatest graces of Christ, of our relationship with Christ, that it must not, you know, make us more confused or kalat yung ating buhay, kundi buuin natin. That's why I think the emphasis of Pope Francis in terms of being pastoral and showing the mercy of God is precisely because of that. That God's mercy and the pastoral care of the church for our people brings about a sense of wholeness. The physical, the material, yes, but also the psychological and the spiritual aspects. That first point, that the healing of Christ is a healing presence that brings about wholeness. Na ang ating pagkatao ay nabubuo dahil sa biyaya ng paghilom ng presensya ng Panginoon sa ating buhay. And the second thing that I invite you to reflect on is that importanteng makita natin na ang naging daan ng biyaya para sa paralitiko ay yung kanyang mga kaibigan. In fact, when you take a look at the gospel, the first thing that the Lord says, no? Take a look at what the gospel said. When Christ, nung binababa nung apat na kaibigan, yung paralitiko sa bubong, when Christ saw their faith, yung pananampalataya ng mga kaibigan, he said to the paralytic, "As for you, your sins are forgiven." May mahalagang aral doon. Ano? Mahalagang aral na ang paghilom ng ating kapwa ay nakasalalay din sa ating pagtulong, no? Na magdala sa ating kapwa, sa Panginoon. Na ang pananampalataya natin ay malaking bagay na nagbibigay ng paghilom sa kapwa. That's why, you know, every time people people ask for prayers for a sick person, for a friend or a relative who has cancer, I always tell them, your prayers are important, especially the family. Because in this gospel, it shows us very clearly that our faith, our prayers, our bringing people to God in prayer is a very important vehicle for the grace of healing from Christ. Physical healing, psychological healing, spiritual healing. That we all come together in faith to become channels of God's grace. The second point to reflect on, no? And the third point that I want to invite you to reflect on is hindi lamang paghilom nito na bilang isang komunidad na ang ating pananampalataya ay naghihilom sa ating kapwa. Pero isipin din natin na kailangan natin hilumin ang ating lipunan, ang ating buong simbahan. That it is not just a one-on-one healing, but it is a healing of our community, it is the healing of our church, it is the healing of our society. And I think we can reflect on this with the paralytic as the marginalized, those who have been paralyzed by poverty, those who have been paralyzed by lives of poverty, of the deprivation of access to opportunities in life, access to material resources, to basic income in life. These are the paralytics of society. And I think we are invited to be like the four friends. And this time, I think, as we reflect on this past year of the pandemic, and as we look forward, I think we need to ask ourselves, we should take extraordinary means. It cannot be simply charity, no? But we must be like the four friends of the paralytic, who because of the crowds, they could not go through the crowds. What did they do? They went up the roof. They took extraordinary means beyond what we are normally used to. You know, it's important that we help. Yung mga ayuda na tinatawag. Maraming naguguto, marami ang nangangailangan ng pag-asa. I think it's important that we reach out to them, to our donations, our charity work. But I think we need to go deeper this time. Kailangan na higit na malalim ang ating pagninilay, ano ang matutulong natin sa mga paralitiko ng lipunan. Ang mga dukha, ang mga walang trabaho, walang mapakain sa pamilya, higit sa ayuda, kailangan na mas radikal ang ating pagtulong. Na ang pagbabago sa lipunan, pagbabago sa bilang simbahan, that we must reform in a more drastic paradigm shift. What it means to be church, what it means to be a community. Just like the four men, we must go up the roof, open the roof, and bring down the paralytics of our society to Christ. I think that is a challenge. And I hope it is a challenge that we will respond to from the depths of our faith. And there is no greater time than during this Advent and Christmas season to really do some soul searching. How do we bring the hope of Christ into the lives of those who are suffering, into the lives of those who are in a very human way, are in near despair, and to bring in the hope of our faith. Let me end with a story that I shared with you last week. Mga more than 2 weeks ago, nag-uusap kami doon sa tutorial program na sinisimula namin sa Diocese of Novaliches. At nakwento nga sa inyo, yung isang bata, kinukwento niya doon sa sharing, ano siya, senior high school, grade 12, kinukwento niya na nagsimula ang pandemya, nawala ng trabaho ang tatay niya, nawala ng kita ang nanay niya. Sabi niya, doon sa panahon na akala ko wala na kaming pag-asa, noon ko nakita ang galaw ng Diyos. And for me, I think that is important for us to remember. Can we bring the hope of Christ, the hope of our faith, into the lives of these people? And I think we need a radical reorientation of our structures in society to bring about greater equality, to bring about greater opportunities of how these people can better themselves, to give them hope, to give them a fighting chance, to be like the four men who will go up the roof, break open the roof, and bring these people to Christ. Hilingin natin to sa ating Panginoon, at hilingin din natin to kay St. Ambrose. St. Ambrose who helped St. Augustine reform his life. And according to the story, the greatest influence of Ambrose on Augustine was that Augustine was edified by Ambrose, by his life, by his example. Can we be edifying men and women to bring hope to people? Pwede ba tayong maging inspirasyon sa kanila? Let us pray for this grace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
With all the trust of the paralytic's friends, let us pray for healing and wholeness of the peoples of the world. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church of God may be constantly at work, carrying out Christ's saving mission through the forgiveness of sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be ready to forgive others, realizing that this is a shared duty of all who follow Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who feel paralyzed because of their sinfulness may find true spiritual healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the handicapped may receive comfort and hope in Jesus, who suffered for all of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be forgiven of their sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the forgiveness shown to us by your Son. May we in turn show forgiveness to all who have offended us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Holy Spirit fill us with the light of faith, by which He constantly enlightened Saint Ambrose for the spreading of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Ambrose you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by the words of his preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, as we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Ambrose, with apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need, to ask your protection against the COVID-19, that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Nino de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Lead us who have been strengthened by the power of this sacrament, O Lord, so to profit from the teaching of Saint Ambrose, that hastening fearlessly along your paths, we may be prepared for the delights of the eternal banquet through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Reminder, tomorrow is the Feast of the Immaculate Conception. So we'd like to invite the families to join us. It's a holy day of obligation. It's also a holiday. So please invite your family to join us at Mass. And then also, if you have time, and please do try to find the time, offer a rosary to our Blessed Mother, praying most especially for our people, for our country, and for the Church. So have a good break tomorrow, and hopefully have a prayerful break tomorrow.